Hi guys. I hope you're all doing well. Today's video, I wanted to show you how I apply my press-on nails. I love having my nails done, but due to other work I do, my manicured nails never last very long. I deal with a lot of boxes, a lot of water. I deal with kids. So they tend to not last. And then I get really frustrated because I paid money for them and they didn't last as long as I hoped for. So lately I have been just keeping my nails short and I take care of them myself. I moisturize them, etc., etc. But to make these videos, I found these press-on nails that do look really good. So I'm going to show you one today. And it's this one right here. I bought it at a regular pharmacy. It's not the cheapest, but it's definitely cheaper than getting manicure at a nail salon. And this one doesn't use glue. It's just little stickers. I thought that they were not gonna last, but surprisingly enough, I thought it was a really good quality. And it did last a long time for me. The last ones I had. This one is very cheery and party evening type of nails. But I love dark colored nails. So here goes. So they come in this little plastic box. Here are like instructions, and we have this little pad to wipe your nails from any kind of particles of dirt or oil, which is really good. But at first, I'm gonna select the sizes of the nails that are usually good for my fingernails. I'm definitely gonna wear a couple of these. Just so you get the entire look for it. And I think I'm gonna probably put them on my ring finger. Yeah, let's see if this one fits as well. My ring finger. I think so. I think these are good sizes for my ring fingers. So I'm gonna leave them here. Now, I think I usually for my pinky, it has to be a really tiny one. Like this, maybe. Let me see. think there's even a smaller one on my pinky. So they have numbers on them, but I couldn't quite figure them out yet because they don't make much sense to me. Oh, I found a tiny one here. This one, very, very tiny. And this one, I'm gonna put on my pinkies. Yeah. So, pinky, ring finger, for my left hand. Then I need these are usually good for the thumbs. Yeah, this is perfect for my thumb here, I think. But I want them to look quite similar on both sides, on both hands. See, this is a little smaller. Also, like I have, my nails are all a little bit different on both hands. We all have tiny differences on right side and left side. So let's continue. I think this is gonna be for my left thumb. Okay, put this here. This is good for this one. Oops. Even though sometimes I like them to be a little bit smaller than this. See, I think this, yeah, this fits better. We have a little tip here that's a little, the edge is a little rough, but then you can just file it later. Okay. And then for this one, which is a small nail, usually a little more narrow than the others. Is kind of pinky like, but not in my case. I think this will fit good here. There you go. Left hand. Then right hand. I still think this is too small for this finger, so let me see. Comparing them here, maybe this one. Because then it might be too much bigger than the left one. They have the sparkles everywhere. So let's see. Yeah, it's pretty similar. It should work. Then this one, this. I always like to compare them, even though there is a little bit of difference between right and left. But I want it to be at least a little bit similar. See, I don't know. I'm not so sure about this. It does look similar, though. But no, this feels small. Maybe not. It's so hard because they are very, very, very similar in sizes, but not exactly. Yeah, I'm gonna use this one. And then I need more pinky. think I found it. Here it is. Tiny baby. Pinky. Nail. Okay. So I got it all. I love the sound of nails. Now, I will, everything comes like taped. Oh, I think I cut that out of frame, sorry. I think it's almost like acetone. So you just wipe your nails like this. I did put some cream before starting this video. I have to keep my nails very, very moisturized. Otherwise, it's just a disaster. And then they wouldn't survive without a manicure. This is one of the talents I wish I had, to kind of like paint my nails myself. I'm not very good at it. But, okay, so let's start. I'm gonna start with my right hand because I'm not a lefty. And I always like to leave the easiest, less challenging for later. So it's just a little sticker. The part that has the little pull is supposed to go at the bottom of your nail. But you can kind of tell by the shape. It's a square-shaped nail, so. Okay. I pull the little sticker and then you just place it and press it on a little bit like that. It's a little crooked, but I guess at the end of the day, not at the end of the day, at the end of this, when they're all in place, it should look quite normal. Now for the sparkly one. I don't usually wear nails with like a different one. I just like everything neutral and for this occasion, it'd be good to put the sparkly one. Number 3. Let me see what number it says. See, it says 5. And this is not my 5th. Finger, so I don't know. I don't really get it. Maybe there's another reason for the numbers and I'm just not aware of. See how it's a little, I don't know if you can tell on the camera how it's a little rough here, then I'm just gonna file it. First, some of them kind of feel really tight, but then I get totally used to them. And also, as you put them on, it gets more and more challenging to pull the plastic on the sticker for the other ones. That's why I do my right one first, because when it gets more challenging, it's definitely easier with my right hand, since I'm a righty. Okay. Let's start this one. And also, I don't usually wear them this long. But it does look really pretty, but I can't get used to them so long like that. So I'm definitely gonna cut them a little shorter than this and file it. But anyways, it is what it is. Which, for me, it's honestly the most difficult part of putting press-on nails. It's because I like to file them afterwards. And that's not easy. Because they're harder than regular nails, than your natural nails. I really like this though, but I love this, but I would like to have all of my fingers' nails in something like this. So the mix and match thing is not usually my favorite thing to do, but it's cute. I mean, it's just a personal choice and taste. Because I know this is very trendy at the moment. But they last way more than I thought they would. And I'm very surprised. I think it ends up being worth it. I think I paid like $8 or $9 on a little box like that. But not only I get to do, I have leftovers, so I get to do them one more time or even two more times or something. And The last time I did it, it was like one of the nails, I don't know if it was a little defective or I just didn't do it right, but it fell right on the first day. I mean, like 5 minutes after I put them on. And then I was like, oh no, is this going to be like that? Then I pressed it on. I pressed that one on again. And it lasted for like a week. You know, I thought it was going to fall while I slept. Oh, there's a little bit of sun shining over here now. I'm almost done anyways. I'm going to set it up for my next video now. tattoos. Directions. The empty box. I will put it back in because it's a good place to store it. The rest. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And subscribe if you haven't already, and if you'd like to see more of my videos, give me a thumbs up if you like this video. I really appreciate you watching and your support. Thank you so much. See you next time.